In previous class, we discussing regarding as an ecosystem. An ecosystem is the self-sustaining organization of biotech and abiotic companies. Generally, as a large size of ecosystems are known as a biome. Large size of ecosystems known as the biome. For example, savanna, grasslands, tundra, aquatic, all these are the biomes which are known for their specialized. So a biome is a very large ecosystem on land having the distinct types of vegetation and animal life. The assemblage of plant species living in association with each other in a given environment, in given environmental framework, is termed as the vegetation, as we discussing as earlier, when plants grow without the human interference, as the natural vegetation. The main constituent of the biomes is the vegetation. All through the animals are also included in them. So the examples are forests, grasslands, savanna, desert, aquatic. All these are the examples of a biome. Now next are the categorization, the classification of the natural vegetation. Natural vegetation broadly classify into the five categories. First, tropical evergreen forest. Second, tropical deciduous forest. Third, thorny bushes. Fourth, mangroves. And fifth one is the mountain vegetation. Let's start from the first, tropical evergreen forest. Now we will start from the tropical evergreen forest. So tropical evergreen forest, with the name is clear, those forests which are green throughout the year. They do not shed their leaves in a particular month of the year. Tropical evergreen forest do not shed their leaves in particular months of the year. Tropical evergreen forest, those forests which do not shed their leaves in a particular month of the year. They remain green throughout the year. That's why they are known as the tropical evergreen forest. These are also known as the tropical rainforest. Why? Because such forests are growing in areas, in regions, receiving as the more than 200 centimeters annual rainfall. These forests are found in areas with an annual rainfall of about the 200 centimeters. 200 centimeters or more. 200 centimeters or more. So these forests grow in areas of a high temperature and precipitation. These forests generally has growing in areas receiving as a high rainfall and high temperature. In these forests, trees grow very vigorously, reaching the heights of 60 meters and above. These are very tall. These types of the forests which are growing in a high temperature areas, high rainfall precipitation areas, in such areas, such type of the vegetation due to as a high rainfall, the height of our trees, these are generally taller. Tropical evergreen forests are the taller. Their height, it may be as varied from a 60 meter above of 60 meters from mean sea level, from the surface area, 60 meters from surface areas. These forests shield the hardwood trees. Hardwood, which is has a less commercial purposes. It is not demanded for the timber furniture industry. These are less required for the commercial purposes, not for the timber industry. Furnitures are not manufactured through the such forest, through the wood extracted, through which the furniture not manufactured. An important characteristics of these forests as the these forests is a dead type of a large number of a species. Large number of a species of animals are found in these forests. Large number of a species of animals found in these forests. Large number of a species of animals found in these forests. Species of animals found in these forests. So important species of animals which are found in these forests are, these are monkeys, elephants, monkey, elephants, one-horned rhinoceros, deer, etc. In these forests, the important number of species of trees are, ebony, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, cinchona, cinchona, shisham, 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 etc. Shisham growing in these forests. So such kind of the forests are generally found in a, these are generally found in a parts of a western parts of a western ghats, western slopes of western ghats, western slopes of western ghats. Yes, Aditya.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, वो क्या अभी सर मैं थोड़ी क्लास लेट ज्वाइन हुई सर आप बता सकते हो अभी क्या
ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट नाउ ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट आर गोइंग ऑन ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट सो ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट दीज आर जनरली फाउंड इन एरियाज व्हिच आर रिसीविंग एज अ मोर देन 200 सेंटीमीटर एनुअल रेनफॉल दैट्स व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट सो दीज आर लाइज इन अ वेस्टर्न स्लोप्स ऑफ अ वेस्टर्न घाट्स and the northeastern states of Assam and Meghalaya. Northeastern states of Assam and Meghalaya, which are receiving as more than 200 centimeters annual rainfall, which are known for the location of a tropical evergreen forest or rainforest. Tropical evergreen forest, which do not shed their leaves in a particular months of the year, that's why they are known as a tropical evergreen forest. These are also known as a tropical rainforest because these are growing in regions receiving as annual rainfall more than 200 centimeters. These forests are those which are growing as a hardwood, which is as a less commercial purposes. Hardwood has not required for the commercial purposes for manufacturing of furniture. Ebony, mahogany, rosewood, shisham, cinchona, rubber are the important species of trees growing in a tropical evergreen forest. In tropical evergreen forest, the important number of a species of animals are the monkeys, deer, one-horned rhinoceros and elephant. So these forests are generally lying in a western slopes of a western ghats, northeastern states of Assam, Meghalaya, Lakshadweep, and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So on this map, as the dark green shaded areas are the those regions which are known for the location of a tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest. Clear? The major areas, tropical evergreen forest. Clear? Till there any questions? Till there any questions? Next are the tropical deciduous forest. 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 So tropical deciduous forest. These forests are typical type of a natural vegetation of monsoon regions. Of monsoon regions. These forests are generally as the growing in a monsoonal regions. So they are also called as the monsoon forest. On the basis of the availability of water, these forests are further divided into the two categories. Tropical deciduous forests categorized into the two categories. Tropical wet forest or moist. Tropical wet or moist. Deciduous forest and tropical dry deciduous forest. Tropical dry deciduous forest. Tropical dry deciduous forest. Tropical dry deciduous forest. So tropical moist, let's start from the first, tropical wet or a tropical moist deciduous forest. Those forests which are growing in foothills of Himalayas. Foothills of Himalayas. Foothills means as such parts of the Himalayas, such part of Himalayas which are considered under the wetlands, terai regions, wetlands or terai regions. Divya, raise your hand. Divya.
Yes, sir.
Terai is an example of a dash.
Terai. Deciduous.
No, terai.
Dry.
T-E-R-A-I. Terai is an example of terai, bhabar, khadar, bhangar. Remember?
Yes, sir. Plains.
Yes, very good. These are the alluvial plains. These are alluvial plains. Terai is the wetlands which has categorized under the alluvial plains. Alluvial plains. So foothills of Himalayas. Yes, Dhiren.
Sir, please repeat the definition of tropical deciduous forest.
Tropical deciduous forest. Tropical deciduous forest are growing in a typical type of a natural vegetation of monsoonal region, which is known as the monsoonal forest, which is categorized into two categories as tropical wet moist, wet deciduous forest, tropical dry deciduous forest. Tropical, let's start from the first, tropical wet deciduous forest. Tropical wet deciduous forests are growing in a foothills of Himalayas in terai region, T-E-R-A-I, in terai region, foothills of Himalayas, Jharkhand, West Odisha, Chhattisgarh, and eastern slopes of Western Ghats, Due to the longer dry seasons, this type of forest, they shed their leaves during autumn season, during autumn season, as each other species has a different time of shedding leaves, the entire forest is not bare at any time. The important species of trees growing in a tropical moist deciduous forest are sandalwood, sal, S-A-L, sandalwood, comma, sal, comma, rosewood, khair, K-H-A-I-R, khair, shisham, bamboos also, B-A-M-B-O-O-S, bamboos, shisham, khair, rosewood, sandalwood, and sal are generally growing in a tropical moist deciduous forest. Tropical moist deciduous forest. Clear? Next are the tropical dry deciduous forest. These forests found in the western parts of Peninsular Plateau, comma, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. Most of these forests have been cleared for cultivation and grazing. Cultivation and grazing. The important species of trees growing in a tropical dry deciduous forests are teak, T-E-A-K, teak and sal. S-A-L, sal. Clear? Teak and sal, the important species of trees growing in a tropical dry deciduous forest. In tropical moist deciduous forest, important species of trees are the sal, rosewood, sandalwood. Important species of trees growing in a tropical moist deciduous forest are sal, rosewood, sandalwood, khair, bamboos. But in a tropical dry deciduous forest, as a teak and sal only. Teak and sal growing in a tropical dry deciduous forest. Clear? Till there any questions? Yes, Aditya. Yes, Aditya.
Sir, please, can you repeat that tropical evergreen forest once?
Tropical evergreen forest, those forests which do not shed their leaves in a particular month of the year. That's why they are known as a tropical evergreen. These are also known as a tropical rainforest because they are growing in areas receiving as annual rainfall more than 200 centimeters. In such forests, as a hardwood has producing such wood which is as a less commercial need, important species are mahogany, ebony, rosewood, rubber, cinchona, shisham are the important species of trees growing in a tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest. Apran, the shedding of leaves, procedure as a natural when the dry conditions are prevailing. Dry conditions at the time of autumn, finishing of rainy season, retreating monsoon season when it ends. Afterwards, due to the dry conditions, such forests, tropical moist and tropical dry forests, they shed their leaves. Means the months of November and December. Months of November and December, they shed their leaves in plains of India. In all over the country, these are as the widely spreaded as compared to all the number of categories of vegetation. Tropical deciduous forests are extended in larger areas compared with other types of vegetation. As compared to other types of vegetation. Yes, Aditya.
सर एक बार रिपीट कर देना वो क्या होते हैं रेन फॉरेस्ट की एग्जांपल
EBONY एबनी रोजवुड ROSEWOOD रोजवुड महोगनी MAHOGANY फोर्थ रबर RUBBER रबर एटसेट्रा Cinchona also, C-I-N-C-H-O-N-A, C-I-N-C-H-O-N-A, Cinchona. Yes, any other questions? Yes, Aditya. Now the next one, thorny bushes, thorn forest. Third category of natural vegetation, thorn forest. THORN, thorn forest. Those forests which are growing in areas receiving as a less rainfall, less than 70 centimeters annually. Forests which are growing in areas receiving as annual rainfall less than 70 centimeters annually are known as a thorn forest. Thorn forest. Due to the lack of moisture, and precipitation, the trees growing in desert areas, they are having the very small leaves and adapted their harsh weather conditions. How? Leaves are transformed into the thorns. Spines. Such leaves adapted their weather conditions, extremely hot weather conditions, through transformation. The adapt of these trees and their leaves, they transform into as the spines, change into the spines, thorns. Thorns, THORNS. The common species found here include as a babool, BABUL. BABUL, the important species of trees growing in thorn vegetation as babool. B-A-B-U-L, B-A-B-U-L, babool, cactus, date palm, D-A-T-E, date palm, D-A-T-E, P-A-L-M, kicker, K-I-K-A-R, K-I-K-A-R, K I K A R K I K A R are the important species of trees growing in desert vegetation or thorny forest. Thorn forest. So in such type of vegetation, they adapted their environment through following ways. They are having the waxy stems. WAXY waxy stems to reduce process of evapotranspiration, water loss, means water loss. Water loss from trees reduce, water loss from trees reduce due to as a waxy stem. These types of the vegetation having the deeper roots which reach till the underground water, why? Because low rainfall, due to the low rainfall, water necessity completes the trees through the deeper roots. Third, smaller leaves reduce process of transpiration. Smaller leaves reduce process of transpiration, and spines, such thorns protected the trees from animals. Thorns protected trees from animals. THORNS, thorns protected trees from animals. That's why as the such type of vegetation adapted their environmental conditions. Environmental conditions. The main features of a thorny forest are that the trees are scattered and have the long plant roots penetrating the deep into the soil and spreading in a radial pattern in search of a water. Leaves are small to minimize the loss of water. Minimize the loss of water. Loss of water. Such type of vegetation has generally lies in a southwestern parts of Punjab. Southwestern parts of Punjab, Haryana. Southwestern parts of Punjab, same as western parts of Haryana. Western parts of Haryana. Western parts of Haryana. Dry parts of Uttar Pradesh. Dry parts of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh. Dry parts of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh. Rajasthan, Gujarat. Rajasthan and Gujarat, known for the existence of thorny shrubs and bushes. Thorny shrubs and bushes. Still there, any questions? Any questions? Yes, till the time we discuss as a three of the vegetation, natural vegetation types are the tropical evergreen forests, which are growing in a rainfed areas. That's why they are known as a tropical rainforest, because they are growing in areas receiving as annual rainfall more than 200 centimeters. Such forests are producing the hardwood, which is has less commercial need. As compared to the important species of trees in a tropical evergreen forest are the ebony, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, cinchona, etc. Second category is a tropical deciduous forest. Those forests which shed their leaves in a particular months of the year. During the particular months means before or after winters, during the autumn season, they shed their leaves. Shed their leaves are the tropical deciduous forests. These are required for the commercial purposes, for manufacturing of a paper, furniture, for which as a tropical deciduous forests are used in a widely. They are generally has a use. The important species are the sal, rosewood, sandalwood, shisham, khair are important species of trees growing in a tropical deciduous forest. Now the third, as a thorny bushes, those forests which are growing in a low rainfed areas, rainfall areas receiving as a areas receiving as less than 70 centimeters of annual rainfall. Such vegetation adapted their harsh weather conditions to reduce as a process of a evapotranspiration. The important species of trees are as the kicker, date palm, cactus, babool are the important species. Clear? Any questions till there? Till there, any questions? So this one for today. Rest we will continue on tomorrow as the mangroves and mountain vegetation or mountainous vegetation. Any questions?